So here with Councillor Tom Druitt, the Regency Councillor, Regency Ward Councillor. He's also the co-finance spokesman for the Green Party. We're going to talk about the budget. Tom, tell us about where we're at with the budget negotiations. I spoke to Councillor David Gibson before Christmas, but I know you've got an update for us.
Yeah, well, thank you, Mark. Nice to be here. Nice to see you. It's been a really, really difficult budget this year. It always is. Since 2010, the government's taken £100 million out of the city's budget every year. So that is, that's now the accumulated effects of that are massive.
Yeah.
We're dealing with the pandemic still. There was a lot of extra money last year, lots of government support, which was really good last year for dealing with the pandemic. But this year, there's a fraction of what there was last year, but there's still, we're still in the eye of the storm. We're still dealing with a pandemic and its effects every day. So whether that's increased pressure on services or reduced income from, the effects of the pandemic on the economy and the various lockdowns and restrictions and so on, that's all had its toll on income. And so you've got a situation where there's pressure on services like never before and reduced income. And what fills the gap? There's cost of living crisis. We're seeing members of staff leave the council in some departments to look for work elsewhere where they can get more money. Obviously, it's a tragedy, but what can we do? The amount of money we're putting into our own staff at the council is significant. Investing in staff, we've reduced the lowest tier pay grade to basically put everyone on the next on the next pay grade, help all of our staff deal with the cost of living crisis in Brighton and Hove, and hopefully then retain staff, invest in staff, and improve services for residents as a result.
Yeah.
So it's, the challenges, as I said, are pretty significant. And of course, it's not just pandemic and 10 years of austerity, 11, 12 now, but also we've got the climate crisis. We're very mindful of the need to transition the city to carbon neutral as quickly as possible. And so really this is a budget with three angles. Our main priority is to protect services for the most vulnerable. And we also have to support the city's recovery from the pandemic and help people deal with the cost of living crisis. And then our long-term necessity is to invest in action to support carbon neutral 2030 before it's too late.